Let's see what I've packed for myself today. 1 bullion cube, 1 conquered grape, 1 Philly cheesesteak, and a jar of garlic pickles. No one will want to kiss me after these, eh, Smithies?
Well, it's their loss, sir.
Yes.
Allow me, sir. It's no use. Shall I send out for some Chinese?
No, those people are all gristle. I want this jar open. Worthless old geezers. Poof. Next!
Alrighty,
Oh, for goodness sake. What we need around here is some fresh blood.
Would you like me to drain Simpson while he's passed out, sir?
No, no. To attract the top grads, we'll need to make a recruitment film. A picture that showcases our cutting-edge technology.
A talkie, sir?
Ah, yes, brilliant. That's just the kind of far-out gimmick we need. And action.
Wow, what a graduation.
I'll say.
But with college behind us, we'll need careers. And good ones.
What about chestnut roasting? People always need chestnuts.
Or begging. I know a place that'll saw your legs off.
Slow down, fellas. I've got a way we can keep our legs and still have a bright future.
Now you're dreaming.
Oh, am I?
Of course! Nuclear power!
It's the job of tomorrow. Today!
Really?
Well, that settles it. For all those reasons and more, let us choose an electrifying career in... line?
Nuclear power.
Nuclear power.
Duh, you thunder-headed stooges are the worst bunch of...
Hey!
Pretty good, huh?
I didn't quite get the point of it, Dad. Why would Lenny want someone to saw his legs off?
Well, there were script problems from day one.
Didn't seem like anybody even read the script.
That was the problem. The important thing is, after all these years of paying my dues, I'm finally getting some decent parts.
You're joining the Screen Actors Guild?
I didn't choose to be a gifted actor, Marge. It chose me. I'm merely a vessel through which genius flows. Now help me make up some phony credits.
Fat guy number 3?
Good, good.
Hey, Dad, it says they need your full name. You only put down your middle initial.
Hey, what the heck is your middle name anyway?
You know, I have no idea. Hey, Dad... what does the J stand for? How should I know? It was your mother's job to name you and love you and such. I was mainly in it for the spanking. But I can't ask Mom. She's on the run from the law. Serves her right for being a 60s radical.
Though she was a demon in the sack.
So, Dad, regarding that form, why not just make up a middle name?
You might as well. You already made up a phony film credit.
No. Homer Simpson does not lie twice on the same form. He never has, and he never will.
You lied dozens of times on our mortgage application.
Yeah, but they were all part of a single ball of lies. The point is, I'm a grown man, and I deserve a middle name.
Hmm.
I know where we might find your missing moniker. It's a bit of a drive, but on the way, we can have a nice father-son chat.
Great. I'll go shoot myself for bringing this up.
This is the hippie commune your mother ran off to when life with me became a living hell.
Wow, look at this place. There's a pond for skinny dipping, a tire for skinny swinging. I can actually feel the good vibrations.
Ouch.
I remember them, Seth and Munchie. Look at those filthy, lazy, flea-ridden... Oh, hi there!
Hey, check it out.
Is that Abe Simpson? Jeez, man, we haven't seen you since Woodstock.
You went to Woodstock?
Your mother dragged us both to that godforsaken love fest.
Oh, bring on Shanana!
Whoa, mellow out, Abe. Little Homer's trying to groove.
Shame on you, boy. Put some damn pants on and then pull them down. Cause it's time for a spanking.
Get a load of Captain Bringdown. Whoa.
Yeah, whoa.
But I want to play in the mud and be a hippie.
Never. What you need's a good long hitch in Vietnam. There must be an enlistment tent around here somewhere.
If I'd have left it up to your mother, you'd have ended up in a hellhole like this, just lying around, never working, without a care in your head, full of long, luxurious hippie hair.
Oh, Homer J., how do you keep your hair so rich and full?
Lather, rinse, and repeat. Always repeat.
Homer J., will you teach us to make love?
Wow, I could have lived like that.
You know, Homer, your mom was a pretty groovy chick.
And a demon in the sack.
Aw, you heard about that, eh?
Anyway, I still think about her every time I walk by that mural she painted.
Oh, my mother painted that for me? Oh, my God. My middle name is right behind that shrub. I'll finally know what J stands for. From this moment forth, I will be known as Homer J. Simpson. It's so beautiful. What a magical gift for my mother to leave me.
She also left her old poncho. Get off of there, Ginsburg.
I'll treasure this poncho forever. Mwah.
You might want to wash that. The dog has a lot of skin and bladder problems.
All right, we got what we came for. Plus that stink rag to boot. Now let's hit the road. Just lying around, never working, without a care in...
My head full of long, luxurious hippie hair. I'll do it!
What?
I'm gonna be a hippie, just like Mom wanted. I'm gonna let my spirit soar and love all of God's creatures. Get off, you stupid dog!
Dad, do you mind? Your feet are really close to my potato.
Your potato? You can't, like, own a potato, man. It's one of Mother Earth's creatures.
Homer, excuse yourself.
No way, Narc. Bodily functions are a natural thing.
Not to mention hilarious.
You know, I really don't appreciate being called the Narc. And that poncho is filthy. Let me dry clean it for you.
Why do you have to turn everything into one big plastic hassle? Mark, you got too many hang-ups. Like, the whole shaving trip. Come on, I want to see those legs all furry and gross.
That ain't gonna happen, bub.
Well, at least lose the bra. Free the Springfield 2, Marge! Free the Springfield 2!
I think you've had too much strawberry wine.
Help! Oh, I've never seen anything like... My eyes have been soiled.
Come on, Maud. The human wang is a beautiful thing.
Homer, for God's sakes, put your poncho on.
Okay, okay. Narc.
it's Homer J.
My man, you've gone granola.
Right on.
Join the hack.
Oh. That was cool. Think I'll stick around. We've got everything we need right here. Good times, sunshine, free love.
Okay, time to get back to work.
Work? But you're hippies.
Oh, we were on a break.
Time is money, man.
Huh? What is this place?
We are the largest organic juice company in Springfield.
We grow our own vegetables and process them right here, and we give half the profits to war orphans.
Profits, profits, profits! What kind of hippies are you? Peter Fonda must be spinning in his grave.
Hey, we're just trying to pay the bills, Homer. I mean, we're still hippies at heart.
Oh, yeah? When's the last time you freaked out the establishment? You guys are total sellouts.
Wait, don't you work for a nuclear power plant?
Look, we can sit here all day and play the blame game, or we can start freaking people out. Come on, where's your freak bus?
I drive a Saturn.
A Saturn?
We used to have a bus. In a way, the 60s ended the day we sold it. December 31st, 1969.
Yeah, an old-time freakout sounds tempting, Homer, but we've got a big order to fill.
Fine. I guess the juice business is more important than the ideals our hippie forefathers refused to go to war and die for.
I suppose we could duck out for a couple of hours.
Hey, we'll call it a business trip and write off the mileage.
Now your freak flag's flying. Let the freak out begin. Woohoo!
Good sense, ill sense, crippling mankind. Dead kings, man,
no. We're never going to freak anybody out with this music. I brought something from my personal stash that'll blow some minds.
Down just a little.
Hey, Square, expand your mind. The doors of perception are open for business.
Thanks for the tip, Homer. Everywhere, daddy,
daddy. Never fear. The cosmic fool is here to blow the lid off your conformist button-down world.
Weirdos.
Hi, Marge. We're freaking out squares.
Lord.
What's in your brand new bag, Mama?
Oh, it's that pair of Dockers you wanted. 48 waist with the balloon seat, right?
Hey, Marge, not in front of the hippies.
Uh-oh, I don't like the sound of that. Oh, please, God, don't let them come in here.
Hey, the intergalactic jester proclaims this conformity factory closed.
Hmm. 15 years of loyal service, and this is how they tell me? A jester with an invisible proclamation.
That was fun. I don't know if we actually freaked anyone out, but...
No. Marge was definitely freaked out.
Thanks, Homer. It was nice to reconnect with our hippie roots. If only for a...
What the hell?
Oh, no!
Oh, man!
Frisbee jammed the juicillator, Homer.
Our entire shipment is ruined.
Pretty freaky, huh?
The only people who are going to be freaked out are our stockholders.
I'm sensing some negative vibes here, but I promise tomorrow's freakout will go a lot smoother.
There won't be any more freakouts. You're not a hippie, and you never were.
Yes, but the poncho...
Please, Homer, just leave us alone.
How could you let me turn into you? But the poncho! But the poncho! Hit the road, Square.